This morning we're going to look at Proverbs chapter 8, and it's kind of a long chapter, but it reiterates to us the value of wisdom, and that wisdom emanates from God. We can almost make a parallel between wisdom and the Word of God. Wisdom is God's Word applied in our lives, and so the writer Solomon, he encourages us to seek after wisdom in Proverbs chapter 8. But there was a song that was on my heart this morning as I was getting ready. It's an old one that you know. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood to lose all their guilty shame, lose all their guilty shame, lose all their guilty stain. And sinners plunged beneath that flood to lose all. The dying thief rejoiced to see that fountain in his day. And there may I, though vile as he, wash all my sins away. Wash all my sins away. Wash all my sins away. And there my eye, though vile as he, wash all my sins away. Dear dying lamb, thy precious blood shall never lose its power. Be glad when that day comes, man, when he takes us to be with him, and we're fully clothed in his righteousness, a new body. And I don't know about you, but I will be so glad when I am delivered from this sin-racked flesh. Can anybody say amen to that?
Dear sins, by faith I saw the stream. Has been my theme and shall be till I die, and shall be till I die, and shall be till I die. Redeeming love has been my theme and shall.
Last verse.
When this poor lisping, stammering tongue lies silent in the grave, and in a nobler, sweeter song I will sing that cloud to save. I'll sing thy power. I'll sing thy power. sweeter song. I will sing thy power to save. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus washes white as snow.
I'm thankful.
I'm thankful for the blood of Jesus. I'm thankful for the blood of Jesus. Oh, I'm thankful for the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow.
One more time. Oh, the blood. Sing it out.
Oh, the blood of Jesus. Of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow. Washes white as snow.
Amen. So thankful for the blood. Proverbs chapter 8. I think my approach this morning to this long chapter is really just going to be to read it aloud. I guess we'll have corporate reading of Scripture this morning and just make a few brief comments as I read along. And I encourage you, if you have your Bibles, read along with me or just maybe close your eyes and hear the words that Solomon writes to us about wisdom. He says, does not wisdom call? In other words, it's calling out. The Word of God is active and living and breathing, and His wisdom calls out. Does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights beside the way, at the crossroads, she takes her stand. Beside the gates in front of the town, at the entrance of the portals, she cries aloud. To you, O men, I call, and my cry is to the children of man. O simple ones, learn prudence. Remember that word prudence, as we saw earlier in Proverbs, is a managed life. And by wisdom, it gives us a managed life. Not that life is not going to have its chaotic moments, but the Word of God applied in our lives brings prudence, a managed life. O fools, learn sense. Hear, for I will speak noble things, and from my lips will come what is right. For my mouth will utter truth. Wickedness, it is an abomination to my lips. All the words of my mouth are righteous. There is nothing twisted or crooked in them. They are all straight to him who understands, and right to those who find knowledge. Take my instruction instead of silver, and knowledge rather than choice gold. For wisdom is better than jewels, and all that you may desire cannot compare with her. More valuable than all the things that we look for. You know, in a world today that's filled with words of deception, and everybody's crying out, this is right, that's right, this is right, no, that's right. The Word of God is not twisted, it's truth. It's a plumb line, as the Bible says, that God takes his plumb line of his word, and he determines what is right by his word. I, wisdom, dwell with prudence, and I find knowledge and discretion. The fear of the Lord is hatred of evil, pride and arrogance and the way of evil, and perverted speech I hate. I have counsel and sound wisdom. I have insight. I have strength. By me, kings reign and rulers decree what is justice. By me, princes rule and nobles, all who govern justly. May it be our prayer that those who are in positions of authority in our government, that God's wisdom would come to them, Maybe pray that those who have the wisdom of God would be put in those places and positions of power and decision making, so that justice might reign and rule. I love those who love me, and those who seek me diligently find me. Riches and honor are with me, enduring wealth and righteousness. My fruit is better than gold, even fine gold, and my yield than choice silver. In other words, the result of the consequences of wisdom is that it's more precious than gold, even fine gold. And the product or what wisdom produces, he says here, the yield is better than choice silver. I walk in the way of righteousness, in the paths of justice, granting an inheritance to those who love me and filling their treasuries. The Lord possesses me. The Lord possessed me at the beginning of his work, the first of his acts from old. Ages ago, I was set up at the first, before the beginning of the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no springs abounding with water. Before the mountains had been shaped, before the hills I was brought forth. Before he had made the earth with its field, or the first of the dust of the world. When he established the heavens, I was there. When he drew a circle on the face of the deep. When he made firm the skies above. When he established the fountains of the deep. When he assigned to the sea its limit, so that the waters might not transgress his command. When he marked out the foundations of the earth, then I was beside him like a master workman, and I was daily his delight, rejoicing before him always, rejoicing in the inhabited world and delighting in the children of man. All of that to say that wisdom is not something that evolves or is evolving or has evolved. Wisdom was there right at the beginning of creation, because wisdom comes from the Word of God. It's always been established. We may grow in wisdom and gain more wisdom and the knowledge of God, but it has always been there. All wisdom comes from what has already been established by God. It is from God. And now, O sons, listen to me. Blessed are those who keep my ways. Hear instruction and be wise, and do not neglect it. Blessed is the one who listens to me, watching daily at my gates, waiting beside my doors. And he sums it up like this. For whoever finds me finds life and obtains favor from the Lord. Whoever finds me finds life. Whoever finds what? Who's me? Wisdom, the Word of God, the truth of the Word of God. Whoever finds me finds life. And of course, we know that begins with a relationship to Christ. Today, if you're watching and you've never entered into that personal relationship with Christ, that's the beginning of wisdom. The beginning of wisdom is those who fear God, have a reverence for God and an awe of God, and receive what God has provided for the payment and penalty of our sins, and that's by the blood of Jesus, as we sang about. But who fails to find me injures himself. All who hate me love death. So whoever finds me has life, but who does not, the one who fails to find and seek after the knowledge and the wisdom of God, they love death. In other words, the end of that is a distraught and destroyed life. Take these words from Solomon today, and let's make it our closing prayer, that God would fill us with wisdom, that God would fill our hearts with the knowledge of the truth of the Word of God. We're ravaged by the world and our flesh every day to draw us away from that. But God has given us the Holy Spirit, who empowers us, who gives us the ability to know and understand his truth and be guided and directed by that. Would you join me as I pray in closing that God would fill us with the knowledge of wisdom, But that begins first by recognizing that wisdom is not found in us. Wisdom is not found in our knowledge, and none of us can gloat in our knowledge. Only God's the one who gives wisdom. He's the source of all of that. Father, we thank you this morning for wisdom that comes through your word, God, from knowing you. God, we pray that you would fill us with all knowledge and wisdom, God. First of all, as Paul says, so we might know the height and the depth and the breadth and the width of your love, God. That, Lord, we would be found in you, Lord Jesus, walking in fellowship with you. Father, we pray today also, God, that you give us an opportunity to plant a seed in somebody's heart today, God. God, I pray that on my goings today, God, you would give me, make me keenly aware of those that that you're drawing to know you, God, and that, God, I'd be able to cultivate that seed that's been planted in their heart, God, by exhibiting love for them and, God, a love for you. God, I pray that, Lord, by your grace, God, if you would let me participate in seeing somebody come to know Christ today, Lord, that would just be the height of my day. So God, I pray that you give us all those opportunities. God, first of all, make us keenly aware and make us intentional in our going about. Father, we love you, we bless you, we praise your name. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Just want to remind you that I began this week, devotions are only going to be Monday through Thursday. And I just need that day of Sabbath, if you will, Fridays. And so I won't be with you tomorrow, but we will be together on Monday, and encourage you to share these devotions with others if it might be an encouragement or a blessing to them. I love you. I pray God's blessings on you. I look forward to seeing you either physically or virtually this weekend as the body comes together. And we celebrate baptism this coming Sunday. And then also, just so you know, the following Sunday, we got more of the little cups. They're in short supply right now. And so we're able to have communion that Sunday after next, and have some real important news, some real praise to share with you this weekend as well. So that's just a teaser for you. See you this weekend. I love you. God bless you. May his face shine upon you. Have a great day.